What if the Earth just stopped? No warning, no sound, just the entire planet coming to a sudden silent halt. The chain reaction would be catastrophic. Winds more violent than any hurricane in history. Oceans surging out of their basins. And days and nights stretching into six-month extremes. Would life survive? On today's episode of the Infographic Show, we're exploring what would happen if the Earth stopped spinning. So what actually happens in the very first moments after the Earth grinds to a halt? The answer is simple. Chaos. Everything not bolted down to the bedrock, meaning people, cities, the oceans, and even the atmosphere, would keep moving at the speed the planet had been spinning just moments before. At the equator, that is roughly 1,000 miles per hour. To put that into perspective, that's nearly three times the cruising speed of any commercial jet. Imagine being in a speeding car that suddenly slams into a wall. Except in this situation, the car is the entire planet. The surface might have stopped, but the momentum of everything on it hasn't. Skyscrapers weighing hundreds of thousands of tons, bridges stretching for miles, cars, forests, and even you would be flung eastward. The Earth would effectively turn into the scene of a global car crash, instant destruction stretching from horizon to horizon. And it wouldn't just be solid objects. The oceans, holding a staggering 332 million cubic miles of water, would tear free from their basins. The momentum would transform them into walls of liquid racing at speeds close to 1,000 miles per hour. In an instant, coastlines everywhere would vanish under towering tsunamis. And those waves wouldn't stop after a few miles. They would wash across continents, drowning entire regions and erasing civilization in minutes. And the devastation wouldn't stop there. As water and debris crashed forward, the sheer weight of their movement would trigger massive earthquakes. The 2004 Indian Ocean earthquake, one of the deadliest in history, measured somewhere around 9.2 to 9.3 on the Richter scale and generated a tsunami that killed over 225,000 people. Now multiply that destruction by nearly every fault line on Earth rupturing all at once. The planet's crust would shatter beneath our feet. Cities that managed to survive the first wave of destruction would be leveled in moments. At the poles, the effects might seem less severe. After all, the spin there is minimal compared to the equator. Near the poles, rotational speed is close to zero. But don't be fooled. Even without the extreme momentum, polar regions wouldn't escape. Tsunamis would still thunder across icy coastlines, and earthquakes would rumble through the bedrock. The poles might not fling you into orbit, but they would still feel the planet's death throes. So even though the planet itself may be still, everything on its surface, including the air, the seas, and humanity itself, would keep moving. And in those first few moments, that unstoppable momentum would turn Earth into the most violent disaster in the history of our world. Before diving into the long-term aftermath of a planet that suddenly stops turning, it's worth asking a simple question. Why is Earth spinning in the first place? The answer goes all the way back to the very beginning of our solar system. Newton's first law of motion tells us that an object will stay in the state of motion unless another force acts upon it. In other words, once something is spinning, it keeps on spinning unless something stops it. Long before the Earth existed, there was only a swirling cloud of gas and dust, which is known as an accretion disk. It was already rotating, and as the particles collided and clumped together, they formed larger and larger rocks. Each collision preserved the momentum, just like a figure skater spinning faster, by pulling in their arms. And as the proto-Earth grew, its rotation sped up. And by the time the Earth had fully formed, it had locked in an enormous amount of angular momentum. And that's because there's virtually no friction in space to slow it down, and our planet has been rotating ever since. So what are the long-term effects of a still Earth, assuming that you somehow managed to survive being hurled across the surface? First, all that debris flung across the planet wouldn't stay airborne forever. It would eventually settle back onto the ground, piling up along the western faces of mountain ranges and any large bedrock formations. Imagine mountain chains like the Rockies or the Himalayas buried under layers of twisted metal, shattered concrete, and forests stripped bare. Entire regions would become wastelands of rubble, where the wind had carried the remains of civilization before finally dropping them like a blanket of destruction. But that is only the beginning. With Earth no longer spinning, the very definition of a day would change. Instead of 24 hours, one full day from sunrise to sunset would now last an entire year. That means 6 months of unrelenting sunlight, followed by 6 months of endless night. On the side facing the sun, the heat would become unbearable. With no rotation to carry warmth around the globe, temperatures would soar into the extremes. The daytime side of Earth could reach average temperatures well above 120 degrees Fahrenheit. Meanwhile, on the dark side of the Earth, things will be just as bad, but in a different way. Without sunlight for half a year, temperatures would plummet to around negative 100 degrees Fahrenheit, or lower. Oceans would freeze solid for hundreds of miles inland, covering coastlines in walls of ice. The air itself would grow so cold that moisture would condense and fall as an endless blizzard, burying the land under thick sheets of permafrost. And as if extreme heat and cold weren't enough, the oceans themselves would begin to migrate. Earth's current rotation creates a centrifugal force that causes the planet to bulge outward along the equator by about 27 miles. That bulge holds enormous amounts of water in place. Without rotation, the bulge would vanish and all of that water would drain away from the equator, surging toward the poles. The change would be catastrophic. Ocean levels around the equator would drop by as much as 5 miles, exposing a massive new strip of land at the equator that circles the planet like a belt. At the same time, the poles would flood under new oceans thousands of feet deep. In this new world, Antarctica, an entire continent covering over 5.5 million square miles, would be completely submerged. And everything north of Spain, including much of Europe, Russia, and Canada, would vanish under polar seas. There's actually another surprising change that would occur as the Earth's bulge was affected, due to a halt in rotation. If the Earth suddenly stopped spinning, gravity itself would feel different. Right now, Earth's rotation actually works against gravity, but only a little. At the equator, where the planet spins the fastest, the outward force from that spin slightly reduces the pull of gravity. It's the same principle you feel when a car takes a sharp turn and you're pushed sideways, only on a planetary scale. Because of this, you actually weigh a tiny bit less at the equator than you would at the poles. For example, if you weigh 150 pounds in Quito, Ecuador, you would weigh about half a pound more standing at the North Pole. That's a difference of roughly 0.3%. Small but measurable. Now, imagine the Earth stops spinning. With no centrifugal force pushing outward, that tiny reduction in gravity disappears. Suddenly, everyone on the equator feels about 0.3% heavier. For a 200-pound person, that is like instantly strapping on an extra half a pound. You wouldn't notice it much day to day, but you would notice it when lifting, running, or even when massive engineering projects had to account for the added stress. But the change in gravity wouldn't just affect us. Remember, Earth's spin is also why the planet bulges at the equator. If the Earth stopped rotating, that bulge would shrink as gravity pulled the crust inward. Over thousands of years, the equator would sink closer to the planet's center, redistributing the Earth's mass. This shift wouldn't just reshape coastlines, it would subtly alter gravity all over the world. So even after the initial violence, the long-term effects of a suddenly motionless Earth would be just as devastating. From mountains buried in debris, oceans rearranging the face of the planet, a day that lasts a full year, and a shift in Earth's gravity, the planet would become a world utterly hostile to life as we know it. Now let's examine some of the crazy changes to our atmosphere and weather. So much of the weather we experience today, from gentle trade winds to destructive hurricanes, exists because of the Earth's rotation. The key player here is something known as the Coriolis effect. Put it simply, the Coriolis effect is a force that deflects moving objects on a rotating object, such as our spinning Earth. In the northern hemisphere, objects curve to the right. In the southern hemisphere, they curve to the left. This constant deflection is why massive low-pressure systems like hurricanes don't just pull air straight in. Instead, they swirl. In the north, cyclones rotate counterclockwise. In the south, they spin clockwise. But if the Earth suddenly stopped rotating, the Coriolis effect would vanish. And with it, so would the familiar weather patterns we rely on today. Let's start with hurricanes. Without rotation, low-pressure systems would still form, but air would no longer spiral around an eye. Instead, winds would rush straight toward the center of low pressure. That might sound less dangerous, but in reality, it would make storms far more destructive. Without the swirling pattern to distribute the energy, these systems would slam into the surface head-on, like a wall of unrelenting wind. And it's not just hurricanes. Today, the Coriolis effect is what creates our global circulation cells, the Hadley cells near the equator, the Farrell cells in the mid latitudes, and the polar cells near the poles. These massive conveyor belts of air move heat and moisture around the globe, creating the trade winds, jet streams, and westerlies that drive our climate. Without rotation, these patterns collapse. At first glance, that might sound like a simpler system, but it would be anything but stable. Without the eastward deflection to spread out the energy, these massive wind flows would grow violent and unpredictable. The boundary between hot equatorial air and frigid polar air would become a permanent storm front, with winds blowing at hundreds of miles per hour. And remember, these wouldn't be short-lived storms, they would be never-ending. The loss of the Earth's rotation would also kill off the jet streams. Jet streams act like steering wheels for weather systems, guiding storms and distributing rainfall. Without them, rain would no longer follow the familiar patterns that make agriculture possible. Regions that depend on regular monsoons and seasonal rains would dry out. Meanwhile, others would be drowned under constant deluges. In short, without Earth's rotation, the atmosphere we know today would completely collapse. Hurricanes would lose their spin but gain unstoppable power, trade winds would vanish, jet streams would die, and the balance of global weather would be destroyed. And if this wasn't bad enough, there's another long-term consequence of a motionless Earth that could be even more devastating – the collapse of our planet's magnetic field. Right now, the Earth's magnetic field acts like an invisible shield. It deflects charged particles streaming from the sun in the solar wind and redirects dangerous cosmic rays from deep space. Without it, those high-energy particles would slam directly into our atmosphere and surface. The field itself is powered by the movement of the Earth's core. Deep beneath our feet, in the outer core, lies a churning ocean of molten iron and nickel, kept liquid by intense heat, some of which is left over from the Earth's violent formation 4.5 billion years ago, and some produced by radioactive decay. As this superheated metal rises and falls in convection currents, Earth's rotation twists and organizes those flows, creating powerful electric currents. Those currents generate our magnetic field. But rotation is crucial. Without the planet spinning, the convection currents in the liquid outer core would lose their structure. Over time, the process would grind to a halt. That means that Earth's magnetic field would weaken and then collapse. And what would that mean for anyone still alive on the surface of the planet? Well, first, they'd be exposed to far higher levels of cosmic radiation. Without the protection of the magnetic field, the bombardment of high-energy particles would reach the surface, damaging DNA and increasing cancer rates worldwide. Second, the sun's charged particles would strip away the Earth's atmosphere, just as they did on Mars. Studies suggest that when Mars lost its magnetic field about 4 billion years ago, the solar winds blew away most of its atmosphere within just a few hundred million years. This transformed it from a potentially habitable planet with liquid water into a frozen desert that we see today. The same fate could await the Earth. So with all the drastic changes due to a non-rotating Earth, the question is, what would happen to life on the planet? The answer is, almost everything dies. Right now, Earth is home to millions, with some estimates reaching into the tens or even hundreds of millions of species. In a suddenly non-rotating world, there's a high probability that at least 90 to 95% of those species would go extinct within just a few centuries. The first casualties would be plants. They depend on predictable day-night cycles and seasonal rains. 6 months of sunlight would scorch most vegetation, evaporating soil moisture and causing photosynthesis to grind to a halt under extreme heat. On the dark side, permanent freezing would kill nearly all plant life within weeks. That means entire ecosystems, from rainforest to grassland, would collapse almost immediately. Without plants, herbivores would starve, followed closely by the predators that depend on them. Next, the land animals would suffer. Large mammals, reptiles, and birds would all be among the first to vanish. They rely on stable food chains, moderate temperatures, and breathable air. In the blistering equatorial deserts, daytime highs would exceed livable levels, except for those species that are specially adapted to survive in extreme desert environments. Unfortunately, once their part of the world descends into months of darkness and temperatures plunge into the negatives, those species would quickly be wiped out. Very few warm-blooded animals can survive such extremes without shelter. Even oceans wouldn't be a safe haven. Remember, Earth's oceans would drain toward the poles, forming two massive super-oceans while leaving the equator nearly dry. Marine species adapted to today's coastlines, from vibrant coral reefs to shallow water fish, would be wiped out as their habitats either dried up completely or sank beneath miles of ocean water. Coral reefs alone support about 25% of marine species, so their collapse would trigger mass extinctions underwater. Deep ocean species might fare better temporarily, but without stable currents driven by the Coriolis effect, nutrient cycles would collapse, starving even the creatures of the abyss. But not everything dies. History tells us that life is remarkably resilient. After the asteroid impact that ended the dinosaurs 66 million years ago, wiping out about 75% of all species, survivors like small mammals, crocodiles, and certain plants endured, and eventually they thrived. In a non-rotating Earth, survival would once again favor the extreme, the adaptable, and the small. Likely survivors would include microorganisms. Bacteria and archaea can survive extremes of heat, cold, and radiation. Some thrive in environments that are well over 150 degrees Fahrenheit, while others live in Antarctic ice at temperatures below freezing. They would likely continue to thrive in sheltered environments underground, underwater, or even inside other organisms. One example is the tardigrade. These hardy microscopic water bears are famous for surviving just about everything, including exposure to space. They can endure extreme temperatures, radiation, and complete dehydration by going into a state called cryptobiosis. Deep sea vent communities may also fare well on a still Earth. Creatures that rely on chemosynthesis instead of photosynthesis, like tube worms and certain shellfish, would still have access to energy from Earth's geothermal heat, at least until long-term changes in the core disrupted that system. Simple fungi that break down dead matter could thrive in the aftermath of widespread die-offs, feeding on the vast amounts of organic debris scattered across the planet. Eventually, they would have to then start feeding on their own kind in a type of evolutionary cannibalism. So while nearly every familiar animal would vanish, the microscopic and the extreme environment specialists would endure. Earth wouldn't be lifeless, but it would be unrecognizable. It would become a planet ruled by microbes, fungi, and a handful of invertebrates clinging to survival in the shadows of a world gone still. So, at this point, you're probably wondering what will happen to humanity. And you might be surprised that our species could survive on a non-rotating planet. The first challenge would be finding a place to live. The new supercontinent circling the equator might sound promising, but remember, half of it will be scorched under 6 months of sunlight, while the other half will be buried in perpetual ice. The twilight zones, or narrow bands between the scorching heat and freezing cold, would become humanity's best hope. Here, temperatures might stay just within a survivable range, hovering around 50 to 70 degrees Fahrenheit, depending on the season. But even these regions wouldn't stay stable for long. As the sun crawled across the sky, the habitable strip would constantly shift, forcing people to constantly be on the move. If humanity could somehow find a way to band together and quickly build climate-controlled domes, they wouldn't have to constantly be on the move. These domes would shield people from the blistering heat of the eternal dayside and the freezing cold of the nightside. Built with insulation and radiation protection, they could maintain stable temperatures while filtering in breathable air. Inside, hydroponic farms powered by nuclear energy could grow food year-round, independent of sunlight. But maintaining such a structure wouldn't be easy. Constant maintenance, limited resources, and constant close proximity to each other would make life inside these domes less like paradise and more like living in a fragile bubble that's always on the verge of popping. Food would become another massive hurdle. Traditional farming would collapse. 6 months of daylight would burn crops to ash, while 6 months of darkness would prevent them from growing at all. Even genetically modified crops designed to withstand extremes wouldn't survive these conditions. The only real option would be building massive indoor farms powered by artificial light. That means humanity would need a near-constant supply of energy, likely from nuclear power, or if we're advanced enough by then, fusion reactors. These facilities would likely need to be deep underground to minimize the damage done by the extreme swings in temperature and massive storms. In this new world, human civilization as we know it would be gone. Nations would collapse, supply chains would break down, and survival would depend on small high-tech enclaves clinging to life in the narrow habitable zones. Luckily, a non-rotating Earth isn't something humanity has to worry about, right? Wrong. Believe it or not, Earth's rotation is slowing down, albeit very, very slowly, thanks to the moon's gravitational pull, which creates tidal friction. Our planet loses about 1.8 milliseconds of rotation every century. Now that might sound tiny, but over millions of years it adds up. If this slowdown continued unchecked, Earth's spin could eventually stop. However, at this rate, it would take 18.5 billion years for the Earth to stop spinning. So it's not something we really need to worry about. Yet. And if people somehow made it through the chaos, this next challenge might be even harder. Watch, could two people actually repopulate the Earth to see what happens to humanity? Or watch this video instead.